This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, this is going to be spectacular. Renee Torres is here from the Melting Pot. Good morning, Renee.
Good morning.
Nice to see you. Oh, it's a pleasure to have you here. I'm very excited about this. We are making, and we were just discussing this, I don't know if the audience is ready, lobster cheese fondue and a flaming turtle chocolate fondue. I can't. I might need to walk away. It sounds so great. Now, take us through some of the ingredients we'll be working with here today, Renee.
Absolutely. For the lobster cheese fondue, we start off with a lobster bisque.
Perfect. Oh, I love lobster bisque.
Can't go wrong with
it. Oh, can't go wrong.
And then you've also got our butter case and fontina cheeses that we've already blended together, some fresh lemon juice, lobster meat, and then you garnish with scallions.
Oh, and then I see chocolate.
Absolutely. So for the flaming turtle chocolate fondue, you've got our milk chocolate. Once that's melted down with a little bit of cream, we're going to be adding some caramel, flambe that, and then we add some candied pecans on top.
And you will take us through the steps to sort of simplify this so that people can follow along and maybe attempt this. You know, we're in the fall, the holidays are coming, maybe people want to try this at home, right?
Absolutely.
And they really shouldn't be intimidated by it, should they?
Not at all. Not at all.
Love
it's a
it.
Great meal to make at home, also to come to the restaurant and sit back and relax, especially with the colder weather coming up.
Yeah, talk to us about the restaurant. For folks out there who are unfamiliar with the location and what the Melting Pot is all about, let us know.
Well, the Melting Pot is located in the Providence Place Mall.
Mm-hmm.
And we've been there for just over 6 years.
And things are going very well.
They're going very well. We do the full gamut of stuff. We do the cheese fondue. We also have salads. We have the entree fondue as well as the chocolate.
I can't take my eyes off the lobster, the chocolate. Renee, you had me at fondue is what you did. Great pleasure to meet you.
Nice meeting you as well.
Thank you for joining us here this morning. This, of course, as I said, is Renee Torres from the Melting Pot. She'll be here all morning long. Lobster fondue, chocolate fondue. It's a fondue party is what it is. You don't want to miss it for now. Back over to you.
I'm here with the Melting Pot. Chef Renee is here. And do you have a favorite costume that you wore as a kid growing up?
My favorite costume was Winnie the Pooh.
Winnie the Pooh,
yes.
That's a good one.
I was a big fan of him when I was growing up.
A little
so.
Throwback there. All right, let's get to it because I'm seeing melted chocolate in a bowl.
Exactly.
It doesn't get much better than
so
that.
So I'm going to start off with sweet. And so basically you're going to use a double broiler at home. So basically a pot with a little bit of water in it, and the second pot in there. Mm-hmm. And you're going to take your chocolate chips. And then you're going to just kind of slide them into the pot. Once it gets to a nice steam, so it's warm enough to melt everything down, as that's starting to melt down, you're just going to be adding your heavy cream.
Okay. And that makes for, an easier consistency when you're
Absolutely.
Dipping items?
So it doesn't make it as thick for you. And as that's melting down, once it gets down to a nice consistency,
mm-hmm.
you'll see
fast.
It's nice. Exactly. It melts very quickly.
Wow.
So.
And now, do you have to buy certain chocolate? That looks like the melting chocolate
this is
pieces.
This is our Melting Pot chocolate that we have in-house. Mm-hmm. We do sell our chocolate, and as a matter of fact, proceeds of that go to St. Jude's.
Wow.
So, once it's to the right consistency, you'll see it's nice and runny. So
looks it'll good to
stick
me.
Stick onto your strawberries and your bananas and everything.
Heck, I'd throw a straw in there.
That's what the spoon is for.
There you go.
And then you're going to add the caramel here.
That's right, because it's not just a chocolate fondue, it's a chocolate turtle.
Exactly.
And anytime you hear that word,
Absolutely.
You think of caramel.
Mm-hmm. So you just add your caramel. And then once that is done,
is this one of the popular sweet fondues that you have?
This is definitely our most popular.
Beautiful.
So that just blends in there nicely.
And then you're going to throw some more goodies in there.
Exactly.
Don't worry. We're actually going to use this. We're going to dip into it. We have another fondue that we're going to make. And I know that she mentioned that proceeds of the chocolate sales go to St. Jude's. We're going to tell you more about that, too, when we come back.
No other show can go from superheroes to fondue, but we do it here on The Road Show. Renee Torres is here from The Melting Pot. We're making fondue. You have lobster. And then, you know, I told you before, I love chocolate. And that over there, you got a lot going on in that. What did you place on top?
What I put there was candied pecans. You can also use regular pecans as well.
As if it couldn't get any better. It does.
Exactly.
We just went boom. We were so happy.
The icing on the cakes.
It is. It is the icing. All right, so tell us what we have going on.
I basically already added our lobster bisque to our pot. Again, mm-hmm. double broiler. Now you just add fresh lemon juice.
Right.
Very nice.
And then you're going to add your butter case and fontina cheeses, which are going to be shredded down. You want to add a little bit at a time so it melts down quickly.
Mm-hmm. And fondue isn't something you can really step away from. You really
got to keep an eye on it.
You should definitely keep an eye on it.
And even the chocolate as well. Just keep moving it around so it doesn't burn on the bottom.
Now, I have a question for you regarding fondue. What do you attribute the popularity of it to? Do you think people just like the fun of it? Is it just something different? Because it seems like any party you go to, people have the fondue going on.
Well, it's a great social meal.
Yeah.
So I think that's what draws people to it. I mean, you get to play with your food while you're eating.
Well, I was already doing that anyway. This is another reason, which is great.
And Renee, I'm assuming we're going to, go away from double dipping with the fondue. Right? Is that like rule number one in fondue?
Well, different rules for different courses.
I got it. Fondue.
Don't do that.
You're welcome.
And let's talk about, the melting pot itself, because you're making this today, but you have a lot of other things that you also make.
Definitely. So I did the first and last courses, which are the cheese fondue and the chocolate. Right. But we do have salads, and then we also do entrees. So we can pretty much accommodate, since everything's made tableside, we can accommodate any diet, any
allergy. Which is nice. That's really nice. You go. It's kind of a big show when you go there to eat.
And we're focused here on the fondue, and why wouldn't we be? It's all so spectacular. But talk about the St. Jude, Thanks and Giving campaign.
St. Jude,
we really need to discuss this. Yeah. It's terrific.
Definitely. We started to partner with St. Jude's in 2003. Mm-hmm. So every year we do a big Thanks and Giving campaign. Mm-hmm. It starts in mid-October, and then it goes all the way till the end of December. And you can donate $10, which goes directly to St. Jude's. Right. And in return for that, we give you a $20 gift certificate you can use from January till the end of August next year.
Beautiful.
It's a great deal.
Exactly.
What's not to love? You're helping out, and you're getting a nice little thank you in return. That's
and
great.
And we all know, we've all heard over the years, all the great work that St. Jude does for kids, for families. Without St. Jude, a lot of people would be, they'd be lost.
Without a doubt. Without
and it
a
must
doubt.
Be so very it's rewarding for the melting pot to be a part of something like that. All you guys must be very proud.
Melting Pot is located in the mall, correct?
It is.
Located in the mall. Holidays are here. You want to do something, go to the Melting Pot while you're shopping and get some great food. What do we need to do right now?
Basically, you've got
just
some fondue
sample.
Forks over
here.
Here
you go, Will. Pick your color, my friend. Choose your weapon.
We're going to duel.
Yes.
You got some strawberries.
A fondue. Yeah. Here we go. What's up? What are we doing?
We've got some strawberries over here. Bananas. Two types of marshmallows. Ones are rolled in crushed
I'm not feeding
crackers.
It to you. I am not feeding you strawberries. There you
and
go.
So you basically just go ahead and dip directly in.
Okay. Oh, man.
Dip this in here.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna go with a banana. Yes. Excellent source
and
of
then
potassium.
Once you take that out. Mm-hmm. I'm just going to kind of twist that and
twist away, Mr. Gilbert.
There we go. Oops, excuse me. Look at how good that looks, though. Oh, man.
Oh, yeah, the twist is key, like you just said.
Oh, and the chocolate spilling on my hand.
Of course.
How
I'm
sad.
Curious. It's a good thing we're wearing aprons.
Get my chocolate go to waste. So.
Yeah, it's. Here we go. oh, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Put it right there, Renee. Beautiful. That is so good. Well, this is Renee Torres from the Melting... What do you say, Will?
I may have a little chocolate.
All right. Renee, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you so
pleasure
much.
Pleasure to meet
us.
You from the Melting Pot, of course.
No double
dipping. All about the fondue and the St. Jude's Thanks and Giving campaign. Visit our website, WPRI.com.